please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Mr. Tulsian, stock of the day today has been one of your favorite stocks, Aurobindo Pharma. Your thoughts on market's reaction to this acquisition, of course, 8% higher on the stock.
See, Anuj, broadly, this acquisition looks to be quite positive, and in fact, that has been seen market giving a response to. But one thing which we wish to state for the Aurobindo Pharma, that this has been seen in a in an accumulation for last maybe about couple of weeks, and probably this breakout, you know, is seen to having given today on this news of acquisition for about $900 million. But what I feel that probably the upside is seen to be more, maybe of about 6 to 7% more, where the renewed call has to be taken if you want to have the short term view of maybe about 3 months. But otherwise, we continue to have a positive view on Aurobindo Pharma.
Mr. Tulsian, the other space which has done well today is power. Once again, stocks making a bit of a move. Torrent Power, for example, up 5%. BHEL in the same space, perhaps, or I mean, allied space doing well. CESC is doing well. Your thoughts here?
Chandu, you need to take an individual call on all. First, if I start with CESC, yes, the restructuring move is seen, you know, maybe happening, you know, maybe the date will get announced in the next couple of weeks, which will, and that's people are in fact eyeing that the company will get bifurcated into four stocks, which all will get listed. So that's the news again. Torrent Power is again, you know, it's a matter of the integrated play, you know, which is a proxy to CESC, because probably after CESC, there is only one company which is an integrated play, Torrent Power. We have seen the Reliance Energy now having acquired by Adani. So that could again be a very good play in the generation, distribution, holding distribution license in Gandhinagar, Surat, Ahmedabad, Bhiwandi, Agra, and all sort of things. So that may be the things, but I don't know whether BHEL can really be taken, you know, convincingly, though we have been keeping the positive view on the capital goods space, more into the T&D space, or maybe the power and industrial space like CG Power and ABB and Siemens. But I may not be too, so much on the TGB, the product profile, you know, which BHEL is having. So we will not be keeping the positive on BHEL for the time being, but yes, Torrent Power and CESC looks to be the good investment play with a time horizon of about 3 to 6 months for the individual reasons given by me from there.
Adani Enterprises, of course, is the other stock that I wanted to discuss with you, Mr. Tulsian, because the gas business has been now separated. In the morning, it listed somewhere around 145, but after that, it's a steady climb to 166. Yesterday's closing on Adani Enterprise was 210. So, is it now again a bit overvalued, the X of gas, the stock now at 166?
Shenu, definitely it looks expensive, because if you, it's difficult to attribute any valuation to the gas business now. But if I take the ballpark and maybe at about 50 rupees, you know, this is definitely looks the excessively valued for Adani Enterprise, and this is what we have been discussing, that there is a great trading momentum, you know, which has been seen in the stock, and probably that is keeping this momentum to take this, and it's risky to take the investment call. One may go as a trader, then, you know, you have the advantage of entry and exit with every rise and fall. But as an investor, I think this is the right time, those who have been holding, to exit from the stock.
Okay, that's Adani Enterprises. Mr. Tulsian, your thoughts on this paper rally? It's been really relentless, and even today, I mean, of course, JK Paper, International Paper, the added ASM issues is helping them. But generally, these stocks have been on a huge tear, Tamil Nadu, Newsprint, etc. Do you think there's any more upside left?
See, Surbhi, if you really take a call on this this sector, actually that the sector has been seeing the advantage for last 6 months or so. To start with, China has banned the import of the waste paper. So the international waste paper prices have fallen, and that has given a big advantage. Apart from that, China has stopped exporting the writing printing paper, and that share has largely come to India. One may argue that yes, the pulp paper prices have also risen by about maybe 60 to 70% because of this shortage. But if you really see on the relative basis, many of the Indian companies, in fact, there are about 20 to 25 paper stocks, you know, listed in the space. And in fact, they are all, majority of them are having their own sourcing of the pulp and all the this thing. So practically all the writing, printing, newsprint, craft paper, everyone has seen an advantage. And apart from that, the plastic ban, you know, which you have seen in Maharashtra, has also seen the consumption of craft paper going up. So those who have been making this this thing, in fact, in craft paper, one can use the waste paper because and you don't need the cost of production is also not very high. You don't need caustic soda, you don't need bleaching of the craft paper. That is giving advantage. So I think overall there has been a margin expansion. In fact, recently also we have seen the price increase of about 5 to 6% happened in the last couple of months, which has been giving them a good margin picture. So taking the, and I think this scenario is likely to continue at least for next 4 to 6 months. So you can remain invested in the paper stocks, those who have been holding it.
Again, is this a flash in the pan and then we go back to the lows on Tata Motors, or do you think there's some sort of a bottom formation perhaps here?
So you can call it as a flash in pan, because this kind of data points are not giving the confidence to the market, because you always remain on a tenter hook. And if you take a relative valuation, when you see that Tata Motors have risen and the Maruti having corrected, or maybe for that matter the other automobile stocks, you know, where the sales have been seen quite good, I'm referring more in context to the commercial vehicle, because there is no compulsion that you should remain invested in the PV space only. It is the matter of valuation. So I think that it should be seen as a flash in the pan, and people, they don't get comfort on the Tata Motors because it has been deceiving the investors maybe for last 1 year or so. So again, you know, taking that into account, we will give an avoid advice on the Tata Motors.
Okay, avoid advice is what you have on Tata Motors. Mr. Tulsian, thanks a lot for joining us. And of course, we'll talk to you tomorrow.